The hepatitis A outbreak is causing some eateries to take extra precautions. That includes having workers wear gloves and washing their hands more thoroughly. Manolo Morales goes beyond the headlines. Manolo?
Joe, I spoke with an expert on food safety, and he tells me the last thing a restaurant wants is to have the virus spread from that establishment. So he also recommends that workers get the hepatitis A vaccine.
It's really hard to get rid of a hepatitis A outbreak when it gets into an area, and the only way is good hand hygiene.
Tom Frege runs a business telling workers at restaurants and hotels the do's and don'ts of food safety. He tells me the hepatitis A outbreak is likely to get worse, so he's telling them to wear gloves when preparing all foods.
If they don't do as good a job washing their hands as they should, then the virus particles are still on their hands, and when they put the gloves on, that stops the virus particles from getting on the food.
He's also stressing the importance of washing hands the right way by using warm water with enough soap for a good lather, scrub for at least 20 seconds, and make sure to scrub the fingernails and cuticles.
If you have a nail brush, use that. That's a great way to get your hands and your fingertips clean. Got to pay extra special attention to the fingertips because that's where germs like to hide, and that's what you touch the food with, is the tips of your fingers.
The head of the Hawaii Restaurant Association is stressing the same principles. In a statement, he says, it's as simple as frequent hand washing with warm water. Not only wash it in the bathroom, but when you enter the kitchen. Frege tells me restaurants can take even more precautions.
If I was a restaurant manager right now, I'd make sure that all of my employees had the vaccine. I'd even pay for it.
Doctors say in most cases, health insurance will cover the cost of the vaccine. By taking all these added precautions, Frege says the restaurants can prevent spreading the virus. Now, I checked with the health department on what happens now to the infected worker at Baskin-Robbins. She is not allowed to work in any of the food preparation areas until the doctor gives her the clearance. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.